This tutorial demonstrates how to use the test case class standard. I use the name standard to describe the type test case in the package aunit.testcases to emphasize that this class represents the standard or traditional test case form familiar to users of the XUnit family of regression test frameworks. Here's the interface that we need to test. We start, as always, with the implementation of the test case. Here we declare the test case class standard with no attributes. Note that the test case scenarios declared in the body do not have visibility to the test case since it is not passed as a parameter. Therefore, the test scaffolding elements are declared as members of the package instead of members of the class. Can be seen here in the scaffolding. The elements of the scaffolding are declared global to the package. And a test case scenario is a procedure with a parameter of class-wide type. Here we have the setup case, which is invoked before the first test case scenario is run. Setup and teardown bracket the invocation of each test case scenario, and teardown case is run after the last test case scenario has been run. Register tests and name. The body of the test case has three parts: scaffolding, the scenarios, and name and registration parts. As mentioned previously, setup case is called before the first test case scenario is run. In setup case, we initialize our the elements of the test scaffolding. The job to perform when writing a test case scenario is to prepare the assert method with everything it needs to ask the question, does the actual value returned from the unit under test equal the value we expect? Keeping that in mind, let's look at the first test case scenario, test addition. Here, by having examined the specification of the unit under test and knowing values assigned to elements of the test scaffolding, we produce an expected value for, or rather an actual value for I1 is then computed as I1 plus I2, and here we invoke the method under test. We then, in the insert procedure, we then assert that I1 equals expected 1. Expected 1 has been primed in the test scaffolding. If this assertion is incorrect, then the test the message we provide will be output. Because the actual parameter of each test case scenario is of class-wide type, this implies that the dispatching mechanism is used to select and invoke a given test case scenario at runtime. If your environment does not support dynamic allocation and slate binding, then you should be using the fixture test case, which is compatible with limited runtimes. In test addition failure, we intentionally cause an assertion to fail to illustrate how the framework reports failed assertion. Test addition exception uses a new feature that became available with version 3.2.1 of AUnit, which allows us to assert that an exception will be raised out of the unit under test. This requires you to write your test case scenario as a procedure, which is used to instantiate an assert exception raised procedure, which is then invoked here. We've also illustrated how the framework deals with a constraint error. So adding I1 to I2 will cause a constraint error. And as mentioned here, this message, of course, will not be reported because the exception is thrown at this point. Name and registration part. Well, it should be noted that only registered test case scenarios will be run. This step has both advantages and disadvantages. The advantage is that a test case scenario that is not yet ready to run can be ignored by simply commenting out the registration step as shown below. The disadvantage is that if you forget to remove the comment, the test case scenario will not get run. It is therefore a good idea to use the Gannett coverage tool to visually control the registration status of scenarios in the test case, especially before checking your test case into version control. And as the last step, we assign a name to the test case. The test suite is a function which is located inside of a package, returns type access test suite. And this should be clear. We simply initialize a pointer, point to a new test suite, and by using new, we assume the runtime supports dynamic allocation. And here we add the test case to the test suite object. Within the harness, we instantiate a runner from the test suite. We declare a reporter, pass that to the runner. Now we have our main program. Having run this program, we see the following output. These are the statements output from the put lines just to illustrate that setup case is called, followed by the runs of the test case scenarios, which are bracketed by setup and teardown. And teardown case is the last method in the scaffolding to run. Our outputs illustrate that two test case scenarios are run successfully, and a failed assertion as planned, and a constraint error. Now, I want to illustrate the importance of running Gannett coverage. The output from Gannett coverage shows the following. We see immediately that the subtraction method was not covered. And this then leads us back to the test case. And we can then remove this comment here and rerun everything, and then the missing test of subtraction will then execute. So to conclude, standard is the test case class to use when one, your application has access to the full Ada runtime environment. Two, you want to use the setup case and teardown case procedures. And three, you want to encapsulate and register all test case scenarios in a single unit in order to simplify the test suite composition step.